Assalamu alaikum, good morning everyone. On behalf of Pakistan's Microfinance Network, I'd like to welcome all of our members here and online, our partners and honourable guests to the annual Microfinance Conference 4. Thank you so much for being here, first of all.
Be having a presentation from Mr. Zafar Masood. Sure. So you can set the scene. We'll go on to Mr. Zafar Masood
quickly
with the presentation and then we'll come around to you. Thank you.
So thank you very much for inviting me to this very important conference, and particularly to this session, which Ali Khizr has very rightly pointed out. It's a very important area. It's a hot topic these days. Everybody seems to be interested in this, and I'll try and do the justice to the topic as much as I could. So as we all know, that housing is one of the basic necessities of human nature, like food, clothing, and provides sense of security and safety. The need becomes more pronounced in poor and vulnerable, and the role of microfinance in affordable housing becomes more critical. The phenomenon is well recognized across the globe. The GOP has also acknowledged it, and concerted efforts are being undertaken through NAFTA and SPP to provide shelter to the most needy in the society. I'm very glad that Pakistan Microfinance Network has dedicated the slot on this topic today for debate and discussion in this August gathering, and given me the opportunity to unveil my vision on low-cost housing in the country, something which is very close to my heart. Pakistan and India construction sector contribution is amongst the lowest globally, at approximately 0.7% of GDP, basically due to its unorganized nature and the housing finance debt, which is housing loan to GDP, is as high as 99% countries like Netherlands, and with US and UK, it's 86% and 81% respectively. On the other hand, in Pakistan, contribution of housing and construction financing is less than 1% of the total private sector funding of the entire banking industry, with even worse financing depth. Therefore, the opportunity is phenomenal for all the banks, but particularly for the microfinance institutions in the immediate future, given the recent initiatives taken by the GOP to promote affordable housing. To dimension this opportunity, one needs to look at adult population, real income, interest rates, etc., as major determinants of housing demand. The sector offers substantial employment opportunities due to its forward and backward linkages, creating an estimated 20 jobs per house for unskilled, semi-skilled, and skilled categories. Another 1 to 1.5 million jobs per annum are estimated to be created in the related industries. This sector, however, has mostly operates in unorganized sector, as I stated above, posing substantial regulatory and legal challenges. Major challenges faced by banks in low-cost housing include lack of data availability due to blue-collared and undocumented informal employment, problems of clean title, prevalent repossession laws, and customer acquisition in bulk. Pakistan has a young and growing population with a median age of 23 years. More than 23% of the population is between 25 years and 60 years old, with 35% living in urban areas. Other than the real income of people, the growth rate of population between the age of 25 to 54 years have significant impact on housing demand. More than 50% of the population is anticipated to be living in urban areas by 2040. Based on expected population growth, declining household sizes, rising urbanization, migration trends, and replacement of existing housing units, Pakistan requires about 700,000 housing units annually just to meet natural population growth requirements. Of the total number of housing units, 350,000 new units are required annually in the urban sector alone. estimated that nearly 50% of the urban population does not have access to affordable housing, let alone the rural sector. 68% of the population, consisting of the lowest income segment, had access to merely 1% of the total housing supply. Low cost, or better known as affordable housing, is housing which is deemed affordable to those with a median household income or below. It is evident from the supply of housing amongst different income groups and their income levels that affordability is a key concern in the housing sector. State Bank of Pakistan devised a markup subsidy study, subsidy scheme, along with NAFDA for low-cost housing, remains confined to the lowest quartile, which is a very good starting point for provision of housing for most needy. Obviously, this is a starting point, and as we go along, once that need is sufficiently taken care of, obviously, some amendments will be required in the subsidy scheme to take care of, slightly higher quartile, income segments as well. From the customer perspective, however, affordability and severe lack of supply, particularly in the urban markets, are big challenges. Access to non-salaried income data sources is a major hurdle for the banks to expand in the sector. An automated solution is being worked out under the auspices of Pakistan Banking Council, which would help banks access the telecom and utility usage data of prospective borrowers. Technology piece supporting proxy income calculation and scorecards development is a must to yield better results going forth. The way forward for low-cost housing finance to take off, consisting of a speedy supply of affordable housing units in urban areas by NAFDA, and structured programs with private sector developers and banks to take care of supply side challenges. I would very strongly encourage MFIs to take the full advantage of this immediate opportunity. The State Bank of Pakistan has taken various regulatory and policy initiatives to complement the efforts of Government of Pakistan for housing and construction industry, which also includes monetary mandatory housing and construction finance targets for banks. Something that we banks are all, jumping up and down on. 55% of the total private sector lending of each bank shall be in housing and construction sector. Given that government schemes are focused towards promoting low-cost housing, the biggest beneficiary of this regulatory challenge shall be the affordable housing sector. SBP has also emphasized on capacity building of bank employees. People and organizational excellence group has been set up by SBP in this respect with a selected group of banks, which BOP is also a member, has devised comprehensive training plan for capacity building of staff on housing and developer finance. Mid-sized banks like BOP are always looking towards niche to grow and make its own place with the competition. Affordable housing, to my mind, offers that space and opportunity to these mid-sized growing banks. Capitalizing on this, the Bank of Punjab has already introduced standard risk acceptance criteria for developer and builder financing to provide structured project financing to eligible developers for construction of low-cost housing, and product program approach is being pursued. Furthermore, given that it's uncharted territory for banking sector in Pakistan, therefore we are contemplating strategic alliances with international players like Pitch, Grandco and Real. They both are UK-based development finance organizations funded by UK government. Real is an innovator and investor in affordable homes and develops innovative housing models in Africa and Asia. These institutions will also extend first loss guarantees to promote financing in affordable housing, which will provide us a very solid base to learn this business from the best in the world. Above all, the education about product availability is, to the general masses, is the real game changer. General Amir is sitting there. He'll bear me on this because, we think that this is something that must be taken care of. In this context, media promotion, seminar conferences like the one today marketing routes, and strategic alliances remains key to promote this sector and its growth in the future. To reiterate, microfinance is a key initiative for financial support to low-income households. BOP can play a pivotal role by supporting the sector as a lender on large scale and has desire to become largest lender to this sector in 2 years. And that can be, you know, sort of the testament of that is that we are the only commercial bank today which is the sponsor of this conference. And I'm very proud of that. In conclusion, while we are a public sector bank, which has a duty to work towards forwarding the larger government agenda, however, in case of housing and construction, we are pursuing this opportunity as a niche for direct lending and financing via MFIs for affordable housing to achieve our goal to be the top 5 banks in the country in the next 5 years. And, you know, taking the advantage of the presence of, you know, Dr. Amjad Saqib, who is our esteemed board member, you know, the board is extremely, extremely focused on this. And they're totally supporting all the efforts of the management in this respect. And we are all aligned in terms of delivery of this, you know, very important need of the people directly, as I said, and through the MFIs. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Zafar Saab. Please, yeah, thank you.